Hi everyone and welcome back, it's Vicky here and today I have a couple of cards using products from the latest release by Simon Says Stamp. By the way, this is part of a blog hop, so make sure to visit my blog to learn all about the giveaways. Now I'm going to use the classic bicycle die. This is a die from the latest release, which is called Good Vibes by Simon Says Stamp. And I'm going to cut out this bike. I'm using this rose satin cardstock, which I absolutely love. This is a cardstock by Tonic Studios, and I think that somehow magically it makes every card look so elegant. So I have cut out the bike and a couple of wheels, and now I'm using this panel, which I'm going to stick it on top of my card base. The card base is a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. And I have also cut out this white panel by using a die by My Favorite Things, which is going to be the perfect place to nest my bike on top. Now I'm going to put everything together, which is actually putting the two wheels on your bike. And there is a little basket as well that you can place at the front of your bike or at the back. Now, I always love to have some dimension on my cards, and that's why I added tiny little foam squares at the back, and I'm going to stick my bike on top of my card. Now, I'm also going to place the little basket, and you can see how it fits both at the front and at the bottom. I decided to place it at the back. Now remember, this is part of a blog hop where we celebrate the latest release by Simon Says Stamp, and there are lots of giveaways along every stop of the blog hop, so make sure to visit my blog. You will find the link down below in the description area if you are watching on YouTube. Now I'm going to embellish my card a little bit more, and I'm using these tiny white flowers. These are called Bouquet, I believe, by Tim Holtz. I have added a huge glue dot just on top of this basket, and I'm going to stick three of those paper flowers as if they are coming from the basket. Now this is a new stamp set which is packed with sentiments, and I absolutely love the font. So there are so many different options that you can use, and it's called Vacation Time, and I used a tiny little sentiment that says missing you. I stamped it with Versamark ink, and I applied rose gold embossing powder by Simon. I have cut it out using my scissors into a tiny little flag, and I have a little piece of paper there, so I am actually creating a tiny flag which I am going to stick inside my basket. And I used foam tape at the back since all the rest of the elements are dimensional on top of my card. Now I'm going to finish off my card by adding a couple of crystals at the center of my wheels. And I think this is a really lovely card, looking super elegant. Here is a close-up photo of this card, and you will find more photos at the end of the video as well as on my blog. Now let's move on to the second card. For this card I have cut out the bike twice out of white cardstock, and I'm using my alcohol markers to color everything. By the way, I'm using my aquamarine set by Nuvo alcohol markers. These are by Tonic Studios actually. And of course you can go ahead and color parts of the bike using your favorite mediums. You can also use colored cardstock to cut out all the different parts and then put everything together. Now for the wheel, I am using a gray marker all around, and for the center and those rays, I am going to use the marker that is actually metallic, which is going to give some shine on this part of my bike. I'm planning to do some embossing, so I'm using my anti-static pouch there, and now I'm going to stamp the sentiment. The sentiment says, "Let's travel together," and again it comes from the same stamp set, which is called Vacation Time. I'm stamping with Versamark ink, and then I'm going to apply an embossing powder by Nuvo in a gorgeous color that matches perfectly the colors of my bike. And I believe this color is called Cool Jade. You will find everything I'm using linked down below. I have stuck this panel on top of my standard card, and I have also stamped and embossed another sentiment from the same stamp set to complete my sentiment. And I created this strip of paper, which is going to give me a place to add that bike on top so that it doesn't look as if it is floating on top of my card. Now my card is pretty much finished. I'm just going to finish it off by adding some drops with my Jewel Drops by Nuvo. The Jewel Drops collection by Nuvo actually is semi-transparent. It is going to give a touch of color, but it is going to dry translucent, and I really love the effect. And here are both the cards that I created for today using the same die. Here are some close-up photos on the cards that I made today. I hope you had fun, that you got inspired. Don't forget to check the new release, it is absolutely amazing. And you will find tons of inspiration along the 2 days of Blog Hop, yesterday and today. Thank you all for watching and have a lovely weekend.